Good morning to all of you. It's my proud privilege to get associated with Bharatiya Vidyapeeth, especially to discuss on production and operations management. And in this context, Dr. Ravi Phadke, he contacted me. And he has, on my request, given me the syllabus. So after going through the syllabus, I thought of sharing with the MBA executives who are likely to attend my sessions. And the session hours which has been indicated is a total 40 hours, and out of 40 hours, 20 hours will be mainly for participants for their self-learning, and another 20 hours are allocated to the session who is going to take it. And since I'm involved in this activity with this your institute, I thought of sharing this, first of all, the syllabus with the participants. So if you look at the syllabus part, you will find that the tentative schedule which I have prepared for distance learning MBA executives, this schedule is for about 20 hours. And during this 20 hours period, I thought the units which have been described in this Excel sheet, where you can see that the first is the concept and scope of production and operations management, where the contents have been given in the syllabus is the nature, scope, importance, and functions of production and operations management, production process, difference between production and service operations, functions and internal relations of various departments in manufacturing unit, production administration and responsibilities, production process. So this is the first unit which I am planning to complete in 3 hours. Next, if you look at the sheet, you find that the next topic would be production planning control, where we would like to learn and understand the objectives of PPC, that is production planning control, and its various functions of common and optional nature, job sequencing, assembly line balancing. So these are the areas we are supposed to cover under production planning and control. Next is going to be facility planning and layout. This is another important aspect where when you put up a plant or any unit for manufacturing, you need to place various equipments and various processes in proper place. So how to go about in that, this part I think we'll be covering up. And here also, if you see from the this graphical representation, around 3 hours have been allotted. And next is going to be maintenance management, where you find that the concepts, need of maintenance, objectives, and types of maintenance. Because maintenance is one of the important activity in the manufacturing, because a lot of equipments are involved, and how the maintenance activity is normally carried out will be explained in this particular chapter. Next chapter will be the inventory management. Because in manufacturing, you are required to collect the materials, and collecting materials and using it effectively, that is another important aspect, where you find that the concepts of inventory management, its importance, classification of inventory system, EOQ model, EOQ, what is the meaning of EOQ? This also has to be explained in this chapter. Model, then with numericals, waste disposal, reduction, basic concepts of material, requirement planning of material. These are the things which we need to include in inventory management. And the last, but not the least, is the chapter that is the emerging trends in production and operations management. So here, the importance of supply chain management, SCM, what is just in time, the Japanese concept, quality control, quality assurance, and ISO certification, enterprise resource planning, that is ERP, TQM, TPM, environment, EHS system, culture, employee involvement, concept, quality circle. So these are some of the areas which we would like to learn. And in fact, since all of you are from the manufacturing, most of you must be from the manufacturing or even from the services sections where you must be working as a senior executives. So many of the things you must be already aware of it. So my activity would be to make you and understand and strengthen your thinking in this production and operation management. And I hope that you will be able to make use of the learnings in your shop floor activity. So to start with the presentation, when we look at the first slide, which I have shown, is the nature or the concept and scope of operations management. So this is the first topic where we are going to discuss on the operations and production management. Now let us see what is the your thinking and understanding of production and operations management. I think you must be having certain things in your mind and you're already experienced guys. Now that area which we are going to dealt with over a period of time. Next is, what are we supposed to learn and understand? Where production and operation management is visible? Is it visible here right now? Or do you agree or do you don't agree? And how to understand this? Let us take an example of any goods and services. So these are the brainstorming which I thought we should stimulate our mind to understand on the production and operations management. So it starts with the natural resources, materials that come from nature. So water, soil, wood, coal, these are the things I think you people are already familiar with this. And it appears to be very simple. So natural materials, human resources, people working to produce goods and services, because the human beings are involved in doing any activity in the production activity, as well as the services. Next is the capital resource, because capital, without capital, nothing moves. So for manufacturing any goods and made by people used to produce other goods and services. So here comes your machines, tools, buildings, etc., for which you have to spend some money. And that is known as the capital resources, which we have to look into. So resources, human, capital, natural. So this is how the subject I think we'll be covering. And I hope you will enjoy these sessions as we progress. With this initial introduction, I think we can make a beginning of studying this subject at Bharatiya Vidyapeeth. And I hope the things will be interesting. With this, I stop my initial input to the Bharatiya Vidyapeeth, and I'm extremely thankful to the Bharatiya Vidyapeeth management for giving me an opportunity to share my experiences with the MBA executives who are already working in various areas of their thank you very much.